Hey, in this video I will show you how to backtest any strategy you want with Python. I use Backtesting.py library, it shows all the needed statistics and also makes a chart with buy and sell orders. It actually doesn't matter which platform you trade on. This script uses Binance Futures charts. I also put here some text guide on how to use it, but in this video I will show you how it works and how to use it in details. Okay, to use this script you have to install the latest version of Python from the official website. You can find all used links in the description. Then go to this GitHub repository, download this script as shown on the video, click code, download zip. Unpack this archive to any location you want. You can use any editor or IDE. I use PyCharm, because I can open downloaded folder as a project. We should install all the needed packages. Open terminal, make sure it's on the same folder as your project. Enter pip install -r requirements.txt. Alright, now you can edit the code. The needed file is main.py. This is an example you can use. I put here RSI, MACD, EMA, and Bollinger. But I remove it, and I will show you how to make your own strategy to test it. First of all, you have to add the needed indicators. I make a new function and name it as RSI. It has two arguments, data frame, and period. As you may know, RSI indicator is usually based on the close prices. So we will use closing prices as data frame parameter later. And the period is optional argument, it's 14 as default. Inside this function, RSI variable is equal, TA momentum, RSI indicator. The first argument is series of the data frame, and the second one is window, it's period of the RSI. And to get it as pandas series, add .RSI at the end. Then return this variable. I use TA library that contains a lot of indicators. You can use any technical analysis packages you want. I will also leave the link to this package documentation in the description. This function must return pandas series with RSI values. Later you will understand why it's needed. Go to the strategy. Here you can add any variables you want. It can be periods of some indicators, or high-low RSI values. Go to init, it's the function where you declare all the needed indicators. For example, I add the RSI indicator. Name it RSI, and you should enter self every time because it's the class. It's equal self.i, I means indicator. The first argument is the RSI indicator function that I had before, and the next parameters are arguments that the RSI indicator takes, its closing prices, and period. You can add as many indicators as you want. Then go to the next function. Here you can describe your strategy, like when buy, sell, close position, take profit and stop loss. Okay, the simplest RSI strategy is buy when the indicator falls below the 30% line, and sell if the indicator is above the 70%. I make a new variable, price, it's equal to the closing prices. I take close prices as actual symbol price, because it's the most relevant. The next function is the iteration. -1 is the last candle for the current step. Then I have to make two conditions when buy and sell. If there are no open positions and RSI indicator is below 30, then open a buy order. Size is a margin you want to put in one order. It's percent value of the total investment. You will set total cash later. Then you can set take profit and stop loss if you want. These are the prices at which the trade order will be closed. If you want to make stop prices with percents, like 2% of the price changing, you should enter 1 plus take profit variable, and multiply to the current price. The same for stop loss price. Make another condition for sell signals. Now RSI must be higher 70% line. I will put the same size to the selling orders, and the same stop prices, but make sure you switched plus and minus here, because it's the inverted order. Alright, now I have the strategy I will backtest. You can make any strategy you want. Make a new variable for a symbol you want to use to backtest. I will take XRP USDT. You can use any symbol from the Binance Futures. To get all symbols, you can use getTickers USDT function. Timeframe can be like 5 minutes, 15 minutes, 1 hour. You can also take it from the Binance Futures. The next one is interval. It's backtesting time interval in days. I enter here 30 days because I can't set more for 5 minutes timeframe. Then I should get all candles for the needed symbol, timeframe, and interval. And make a new instance for the backtesting. Inside this, candles info, the strategy you made before, cash is the money you want to invest into this strategy. Margin is leverage, this number is the leverage, now I have x10. Commission is the broker commission for each order. Binance takes 0.02% for opening position and 0.05% for closing it. So I set it as 0.07%, this is approximately the actual value. Then run the strategy, and print all results in the console, and also you can see charts with the results. Okay, the script is done, and now I can start it. It can take some time, because it's getting charts from the Binance Futures. And now I got some results. It shows the duration is 30 days. Equity final is the final value of the cash after the backtesting. As you can see, this strategy makes $3 in a month for XRP USDT. It shows how many trades we have after this. And see the win rate value is 45%, but it's still in profit, because take profit is 3%, and stop loss is 2%. Then go to the chart. It's HTML page that opens on the browser. The upper chart is the money liquidity during this strategy performing. The next one is profit and losses, you can see green and red arrows, when it was profit or loss order. This dashed line is one order, it starts when order opens, and ends with ending it. This arrows also shows when the order is closed. There is also a chart with the indicator I used, it's RSI. There will be all the indicators you added to the strategy. This strategy is the simplest RSI. Don't take it as the main scalping strategy. Okay, then I will show you how to add more indicators to the strategy. It will be EMA. Make a new function for this. It contains the same arguments, data frame, and period. I will use the TA library as well. And this function must return pandas series with EMA values. Then go to the strategy. You can add EMA period here, but it's not necessary because the period is the optional parameter. In the init, declare a new indicator instance for the EMA, in the same way as for RSI. In the next function I have to add something. In the buying condition add, the last close price must be above the 200 EMA. And in the selling, the last closing price is below the EMA. I have to say it's not good strategy at all, but I want to show you how it works. If I run the backtesting, you see I get worse results. I have only 10 cents profit. It doesn't matter what strategies I just shown, make your own, customize it to get better results. Alright, now I will make one more strategy to show some other features. I will use Bollinger Bands indicator without take profit and stop loss. The strategy is, buy when close prices crosses down lower band, and wait for the price to cross the upper band. Then close position and open sell order with the same amount. It will be only 5% of the investment for one order, so we won't lose all the money. Okay, create two functions for high and low bands. These bands have default parameters. Go to the init, declare these indicators here in the same way as before. Go to the strategy description, and I remove the RSI strategy I used before. First condition is buy. Before last close price is above the low Bollinger line, and last one is lower the line, that means the price is crossing down the Bollinger line. If there is no open position then just buy. Size is 5%. I made this condition for the first order. If there is a short position, that was open before, then close it, and buy with the same size. Make another condition for the selling. If the price crosses up the high Bollinger band's price, then, if there wasn't position, place sell order. If there is open long position, close it, and place short position with the same size. As you can see I don't use stop orders now. Let's try to run the script. As you can see the final result is -$1 for XRP USDT, but the peak was +$9, that's because of such fast and high price changes. The best market behavior for this strategy is when the price is moving around the same price interval. Okay, the next thing I want to show is how to test some strategy for all the coins from the Binance futures. Get all symbols from Binance using getTickers USDT function. I add some variable to store results for each symbol. Then make a loop for each symbol from the all symbols list. And put all these lines inside this loop. Remove printing and plotting results. And then I have to add the result for the current symbol to the data variable I made before. I want to get only return value, it's the sixth one from the backtesting result. And put it inside try except construction to prevent the script from crashing. Then make a new variable, result. It's a data frame of the data variable that contains a list with symbols and return values. Make columns, just for convenience. Add the last line to the data frame, it's a sum of all returns. And then just save it as Excel file. Okay, let's try to run the script, it will take some time because the script is backtesting the strategy for over 200 trading pairs. Okay, after some time the script finished its work. And as you can see the Excel file has appeared in the same folder. There are all the symbols and the profit value as a percentage. The total value is the sum of all profit values, I made it just to check if it's positive or negative value. I have to say the Bollinger Band strategy is really profitable for the last 30 days, you can see there is even 85% profit for near USDT. But make your own strategy and customize it to reduce loss orders. I will put this script to the same GitHub page. I hope this tutorial is understandable for you. Leave a comment if you get some question. Thanks for watching.